Testing thumb IP flexion. You will have your patient's hand in a supinated position on a flat surface or table as shown here. First thing you will have your patient do is to curl their thumb inward into their palm as much as they can go. Okay, now bring it back out. Because she's able to do that, I would grade her as a 3. I will now proceed forward to test for a 4 or a 5. The first thing I will do is I will stabilize the proximal phalanx of her thumb, and I will apply resistance to the distal phalanx of her thumb while having her perform this position about halfway. So go about halfway in range. Okay, I will apply resistance, so go ahead, resist me. 3, 2, 1. If she could not bring her thumb into flexion while in this position, then you can have her in a gravity-limited position. But keep in mind, the thumb is very small, and you're not really eliminating that much gravity. But anyway, that's besides the point. So you'll have her in this position, and you will ask the patient to curl their thumb towards the ground as far as they can go. And because she's able to do this, that would be a grade 2. If there is minimal movement, then you will palpate for the flexor pollicis longus tendon. Now, why I'm palpating for the tendon movement is because, if you remember your anatomy, the muscle belly of this muscle is all the way in the forearm. So I want to see right here the tendon in the proximal phalanx to see if there's any movement. If I feel movement, that is a grade 1. And if I do not feel any movement, it's totally stagnant, that is a grade 0.